embarrassed to say that it just took me about 10 minutes to find a record button, so probably shouldn't be making videos anymore. Listen, yeah, the thing is, I know I said I was going to go away for 2 weeks, that I'd be back, I'd share some productivity hacks with you, you know, give you some feedback, and that things were going to keep going on as normal, but in reality, that didn't happen, did it, you know? The problem is, I've been really busy just kind of growing my hair. Those productivity hacks were so good that I haven't had time to actually make videos because I've been so productive with other stuff, you know? Better late than never, so here it is. You know, here's part two, productivity hacks. I'm gonna keep this short and sweet for you guys, just in case I disappear mid-video for another 3 months and you never see me again. You know, we just gotta get this done whilst we're still here. So I've boiled it down to 5 main things that I've been doing the last few weeks that really have helped. Someone like me who is absolutely hopeless, if I can be a productive human being, then the rest of you should have absolutely no trouble whatsoever. First up, number one is just make a list every day, man. Every morning I've woken up and I've written down a list in this book right here, which is secret, so you can't see what I've written. Literally write down a list of things I want to accomplish that day. Sometimes I'll try and like boil it right down to 3 main things that I want to get done in that day. Sometimes it'll be a longer list, but the fact of the matter is I've written down everything I want to accomplish and it's there for me to see whenever I need to check it. That way nothing gets forgotten. I can cross things off as they're done and it just kind of gives me a goal to reach for that day instead of me just sort of wandering around aimlessly and being like, oh, what should I do today? I don't know. We don't want that. Literally, wake up in the morning. First thing you need to do after brushing your teeth, showering, you know, the normal things, make a list of everything you want to accomplish within that day. And a little bonus tip onto that is I have been kind of doing it in a bullet journal style. Now, whilst this isn't a bullet journal, if something from the day before hasn't been crossed off the list, I'll then transfer it over to the next day. If it doesn't need to be done anymore, I'll just cross it off entirely. But that way, it's kind of like keeping me in check and making sure that everything that wants to be done is done. And it just keeps ticking over until it's off the list. Number two, which kind of ties in back with number one, and that is to keep a routine or make a routine and then keep that routine. Now, as much as I love winging it, which 99% of my life so far has been that, as soon as I've introduced a little bit of routine, it kind of did increase my productivity a fair bit. So that can be something as simple as waking up at the same time every morning, having like an hour or two where you sort of brush your teeth, eat breakfast, go to the gym, and then just make sure you sit down by, say, 11 a.m, crack on with your work, get your to-do list done, then have like a few hours in the evening where you relax. And like, if you try and do that 4, 5, 6 days a week, I guarantee you will see results. Just do it, give it a try. I hate routine, but it does help. Number three, and that is build good habits. Again, kind of tying in with number one and number two here, you've seen a bit of a theme, like everything's kind of interrelated. It's not just one thing you're gonna do to increase productivity, it's sort of like a whole batch of interrelated things. Back to the point, build some good habits. Nearly forgot what I was saying. Something that's really helped me with that is this app called Productivity. It's like a habit tracker, so you kind of put in what you want to sort of start doing every day or build a habit out of. Then you tell it when you want it to remind you to do it, and then each day you kind of just cross off the list. And you can have as many things as you want, send you reminders. This isn't a paid sponsorship, unfortunately. It is something that's been helping me. So like, easy things to start with, you know, like getting up early and cooking breakfast, or going to the gym 3 times a week, making a to-do list every morning. Like, if you put those into the app and make that a daily habit, becomes part of your routine, then you can see where I'm going with this. Overall, your productivity is gonna increase. You've got to kind of change the way you're living your life, not just sort of look for a quick, easy fix. Sorry, man, I know. Moving on to number four, which to me is the most vital point I'm gonna share with you today, and that is build a good, solid foundation for productivity and creativity to happen. Now, whilst I've been busy growing my hair, I've been doing a lot of thinking. I kind of guess, like, you need to make sure that your day-to-day life is good first, or at least beneficial for what you're trying to achieve, before you try and sort of hustle and achieve like this massive goal or try and be a more productive human being. Because if you're working in fact, let me just list out 4 or 5 things that I think you need to sort of work on before you can be creative and productive, and that is sort of better sleep, better diet, a clean, uncluttered workspace, same with your home, and sort of removing yourself from stressful environments or situations as much as possible. Because think about it, like, if your day-to-day life, you're sort of stressing out, you're worrying, you're getting into arguments, you're wasting time looking for things because everything's so messy, you're distracted constantly by like all the things around you, like, dude, you're not gonna get anything done. So fix that first, then I promise you it'll be like 10 times easier to get where you wanna be. Finally, number 5, bring it home. Is to just spend time with the right people. Like, you know, they say that you're kind of the sum of the five people you spend the most time with. It's kind of true, and there isn't. Like, if you're spending your time around people who don't want to get anything done, they're really unproductive, they have no desire to sort of achieve anything, that's going to rub off on you, man. But then spend one day with someone who spends the whole day telling you how much they want to achieve, all these cool things they want to do, and you're going to sit there and think, man, I want to do those things. I can do those things as well. And I promise you, you'll change your mindset like that, and you will start achieving things and being a more productive person. So, like, think about who you're spending time around. I'm not saying, like, cut out your friends. Just don't, if that person is a really dragging you down kind of person, if you're trying to get something done that day, don't spend time with them, or at least try and change the way you interact with them, you know? So think about it, it does make sense. Anyway, guys, that's my five things that I've kind of been trying to maintain over the last few weeks. I honestly really have pushed my productivity through the roof. I might not have been making videos, but everything else I've been doing has sort of been going overtime. So have a think, leave some feedback down below, man. Like, I'd love to hear what you guys think. And I know I always say this, there will be more videos coming, I promise. And they won't all be sitting down boring like this. See you guys soon. Peace.